Okay, if you have an Android 14 or newer phone, there's a good chance that it can actually run as a webcam just by going into settings and flipping the USB device into webcam mode. I'm going to show you how to do that and what it looks like, and even compare it to what the camera feed looks like coming from the native camera on a Google Pixel phone. Let's go. All right, so the first thing I want to do is actually get this set up, and the way to do that is to go into settings, then you're going to go into your connected devices, then you'll click on USB, and then you will find the webcam mode and select that, and you're done. All right, so let's have a look at what that looks like in terms of a camera feed coming in through Windows through USB-C. All right, so this is the Android built-in webcam, basically from Android 14, set up as webcam over the USB-C connection, and it just goes to the default kind of one-time zoom camera. So that way you can't really select the camera that you want, even if you have multiple cameras on the device. It just is gonna default to that one, and it's only gonna actually output at 1080p. So you can go into 1080p 60 frames per second or 30 and go down from there, but you can't use the 4K output, for example, on the device, even if you have a very fast, and I've tried this with a Thunderbolt connection using a Thunderbolt cable, you know, 3.2 Gen 2, it still doesn't give me anything higher than 1080p with 60 frames per second, which I think is pretty good and okay, but to me, I would say that the image kind of looks more or less like a webcam image. It's not really giving me the same kind of quality like I had when I turned on Epoch Cam, for example, and set up the iPhone as a webcam. So, you know, normally I would say use your phone if you don't have a great webcam or you don't want to pay $200 or $300 for a quality one. But for this one, even though the camera is pretty good on the Pixel devices, I don't think it's really doing everything that it can do in terms of the kind of computational photography. I think it's just outputting a normal USB feed. There's not a lot of dynamic range that I can see. It's kind of doing pretty well with fairly low light. I think my whole room looks pretty well illuminated, so it's getting a lot of light into the sensor, but to me it looks like a webcam and not as good as, say, the iPhone's camera, again, through Epoch Cam or Continuity Camera. And I was actually curious to see what it would look like recording natively on the device itself. So I recorded that and actually exported the MP4 off the phone and into my timeline to see what that would look like. All right, so this is the built-in Android camera for the Pixel Fold, just so I could compare what it looks like, you know, from the camera inside the device versus what's going out of the USB connection. Because I have a suspicion that it's gonna record better video perhaps with the onboard kind of camera, given that it's got more of a computational bit of photography happening. Maybe it'll give me more dynamic range, but I will take that and put it on my timeline and kind of compare the two and see how they look compared to the webcam feed out of USB-C and the one that's recording to the local device. And as you saw, it didn't look any better than really the webcam feed coming from the phone itself. If anything, I had to do a little bit of conversion because it didn't like the codec in my video editor. I'm using Camtasia 2023 to edit. Didn't like the recording directly from my Android phone editing that film. So I'd actually convert it to a different video version, and I think I lost a little bit of quality there. But it didn't look much better either way, even when I reviewed the two on the device versus what I captured in Windows. So I know that there are other options that you can get through Google Play Store, for example, like DroidCam. To me, though, I tried that out. I actually paid for the DroidCam X version. It was about $5. I had to install the older version of the software, which looked very outdated. Got everything working on an older phone, not on an Android 14 device, the Pixel that I just showed. But it was a little bit, you know, it was dropping frames. It wasn't that smooth in terms of its output. Then I thought maybe, well, I'm using the older version of the app. There's a newer one, so I went to the newer website. I grabbed the newer client, version 7, which is basically a stripped-down version of open source OBS. Then I tried that one out, and it was a little bit better, but it also prompted me to grab the app from my phone, you know, in terms of the OBS DroidCam X app,
And to get rid of the watermark, it actually wanted another $14.99. So you'd have to spend $20 to get those two different apps. And it was still kind of dropping frames and not doing super well over Wi-Fi. So I would say wait until you have an Android 14 or newer phone that has that USB webcam capability. And it did a good job in terms of, you know, looking like a webcam. Didn't look quite as good as the iPhone, but it looked pretty good. So if you don't have a webcam, you want to get this set up. It's a little bit difficult in terms of getting that on a tripod, getting everything started, making sure it's connected through USB. So hopefully this review helps. If it does, give me a like. Otherwise, subscribe to my channel for more tips like this and other camera tips and software tips. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.